You are listening to the Sauce Podcast, recorded live deep beneath historic downtown Seneca Falls, New York, in the FingerLakes1.com Stew Studios, featuring Dandy, Aaron D, Saucy, Yo, Media Stew, Pony Sometime, and now.
Good evening, Sauce Pod streamers worldwide. It's me, Tony Sometimes, and this is episode of number 56, the Lawrence Taylor episode of the Sauce Pod, recorded live inside the FingerLakes1.com studios beneath historic downtown Seneca Falls, New York. You know the drill. Today is June 4th, 2012, and tonight we're going to be talking about Angry Brad's Garage Sale, zombies and real-life flesh eaters, the best boxing instructor video ever, a pot-smoking mom from Arizona, a cleaning fairy in Ohio, and an offer to soothe Dandy's dog, and much, much more.
Oh, now I know that story. Okay.
Per usual, I am joined up here in the FingerLakes1.com studio tonight with my sauce compañeros, Dandy Aaron D, who's en route. He's not here yet.
He's not.
If he was, he'd be.
There he is. Look at that.
And Saucy Joe.
Greetings, everyone.
And a very special guest tonight in the studio, friend of the show, Angry Brad.
How's it going?
Welcome, Brad. Welcome back.
Thank you.
It's your third time.
This has got to be four now.
Third or fourth. The first time,
you're almost in the five
Scotty
timers club.
V took a lot of the.
Right, you were here.
I was here,
but
actually, he was the funniest that night. Some of the things that you said that night were pretty funny.
That's where you got your nickname, Angry Brad, I believe. That episode.
I think it was
because you didn't say anything. You just kind of. Well, you did, but.
I just kind of hung out for the most part.
You've never lived up to your nickname since.
Yeah, I'm not sure. Scott came up with that. I used to slam shit at work, and now I'm more calm.
Which is why it's funny, because you don't seem angry at all. But
here we go.
Hey, we got Dandy
digital
right here.
Digital calls. Put him on the air.
Yeah, hold on a second. Hey, Dandy.
Hey, both doors are locked.
Oh, you're locked out of the old studio, huh?
Yep.
I'll send a person.
We'll send all our right. best guy down.
I may personally come down.
Sounds good.
Okay. Good news, guys. I don't know if you heard, but...
Dandy's here. Do you want me to go down and get him? I can.
Sure, why not? I have to man the controls.
Okay, you talk to Brad more about his lack of living up to his nickname.
I'm coming for you, Dandy! So, Brad, you had a garage sale this weekend.
Yeah, it was a couple weekends ago.
Oh, okay. And Saucy Joe showed up at it.
He did, him, his wife, and his kid.
Did they know it was your garage sale when they got there?
I don't think they noticed it was mine until Saucy Joe's kid walked in the garage and started checking shit out.
And then you emerged and...
Yeah.
Wow. Did you, like, plan that garage sale for several weeks, or was it, like, a spur of the moment?
It was a... It was like a community garage sale.
That's the way to do it. It becomes an event.
Yeah, there were like 12 or 13
sure.
of them.
And anybody that likes to go to garage sales would love to go to one street where there were 12 garage sales.
Oh, absolutely. That's a great neighborhood to go to if you're looking for a good shit.
For a good garage sale? Quality merchandise?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, some people that go to garage sales will literally plan their whole day around it and then hit up various garage sales.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
And some are just bargain hunters. Some are folks that try to buy something and then resell it, like on eBay, maybe.
Yeah, or look, at another garage sale.
Yeah?
Yeah, I know quite a few people that do that.
My wife has a garage sale. Or my family, my mother, my sister, my wife, they do it. Probably every 3 years they'll have a garage sale. And my wife wanted me to get rid of a lot of my stuff. I had a lot of extra golf shirts. So I forbade her to give away all these golf shirts. And anyways, long story short, later that weekend of Dandy's here, everybody. He's just hooking up his stuff.
He's like a wild animal.
And I go to the golf course, and on the first tee, there's a guy I know. He's wearing a familiar-looking golf shirt. I said, hey, I thought I got a golf shirt just like that. He's like, oh, yeah, I love it. He goes, this is great. He goes, I just bought it at a garage sale. I said, was that garage sale at 117 Tony Sometimes Lane?
Yeah.
And he says, as a matter of fact, it was. And I knew that I'd been thwarted. And what was worse is he was like, yeah. Before he told me, I realized for sure it was mine. He's like, yeah, it was like $2.50.
Oh, man.
This was one of my rotation shirts, you know. Probably like a $45, you know, golf shirt. So that was disappointing. Just nonetheless, to see my shirt on another person's body, and it was his. It wasn't mine. That was my shirt. But it wasn't. At that point, it was his. But it was mine. You know what I mean?
I do. That's grounds for eating someone.
Yeah, which there's been a lot of going on. Dandy, how's it going? Welcome.
Great.
Got caught up at golf league?
I did.
That'll happen. How did you play?
Actually, not too bad.
You turn on his microphone.
Oh, yeah.
You can't
yeah,
make any comments without a microphone.
There you
I
go.
I can't hear nothing. I don't know yet.
Look at yourself on the monitor right
wow,
now.
Wow, look at that shit.
Look at you got lights behind you and whatnot.
You play here in
some look at that, you're like an idiot.
It's pretty crazy.
Yeah.
That's, I like it,
that's
though.
Live right there. I mean, there's no delay. We're getting down with no delay right now.
That's a program switcher. For those of you listening, and actually those of you watching, because I guess you won't know what the heck we're talking about, we got a studio monitor in here, so everybody in the, what would you call that out there? The stage? The set.
You want to call this a set? Sure, let's call it a set.
Can see the live program as it happens. So
this program is live. We're doing it tonight.
So yeah, one thing we wanted to talk about is Dandy powers up his Macintosh. Is all this people eating other people that's been going on in the news lately. You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
There are three instances. Let's see here. A naked man who was eating the face of another naked man on a Miami highway ramp was shot and killed by a police officer.
That's the most popular of the three.
Yep, that's number one.
As far as popular eating people story goes.
Number two. A porn actor who reportedly killed a man in Canada dismembered his body and ate flesh from his corpse, fled Canada, and was eventually caught in Germany. So that's number two.
All right. That was less popular.
I didn't hear about that one.
See?
And then number three. A Maryland man allegedly admitted to eating the heart and brain of his dismembered roommate.
Yep.
And that's number three.
Engineering students, I believe, was that story. And the guy's younger brother found the body parts in the basement in like a tin. And he was like, what are these, brother? And his brother was like, oh, those aren't anything. They're certainly not human. And then the kid went and told his dad anyway.
Skeptical.
Yeah. Was like, no, I bet you they are human, even though he said they weren't humans. So he went and told his dad. And then his dad went to look, and they weren't there. Like they had moved mysteriously, whatever. And then the police were called in, and the police found them somewhere.
And then he admitted it, right?
And then he admitted that he ate the brain and heart of that guy, parts of.
That shit almost happened to Angry Brad when he woke me up when we used to live together once.
You almost ate his heart
brain. You almost ate me?
Fuck yeah.
When the fuck was that?
That night.
That one night. Really
that one that night you night. Fucking woke me up.
That could have been where I got my name too, I guess. The whole Angry Brad part.
What do you mean?
I must have been angry at you to try to wake you up.
I don't know. Can't remember. I just remember I wanted to eat your heart and brains.
Speaking of eating hearts and brains, that brings to mind another great brain and heart eating story that happened to the great band Mayhem.
Yeah,
back in
I watched that documentary.
What was that documentary called?
I can pull it up. It was about some like Finnish, Swedish fucking death metal band.
Swedish, yeah, Swedish. Mayhem. And now, so Dead was one of the guys. The band, he ended up shooting himself with a shotcun.
They used it as their fucking CD cover.
They did use it as their CD cover.
Oh,
later.
I do remember that.
And then Euronymous, one of the other guys in the band,
he's the one that's in prison.
He claims that, no. He's dead. Euronymous is also dead because he was killed by Varg Vikernes, Count Grishnak.
And that's the one that's in...
He's actually out now. He served his time.
Oh, he got out?
He served his 20 years and he's out.
Yeah, because it was in the late 80s, right?
Right, and this is like in a country where even if you murder someone with like by stabbing him, I think it was 27 times or whatever, you're out in 20 years. And
well, isn't it Sweden has like the lowest crime rate in the world or some shit?
Yeah,
and they also have the most lax laws. So
right,
you,
right.
Have, you know,
we don't prosecute anybody for anything, so we don't have a crime rate. It's awesome. No, he, Euronymous, they reportedly he claimed that he ate parts of Dead's brain, but what he did definitely do was make necklaces out of his bits of his skull. Like he found this guy, his bandmate Dead, whose name was also Dead, shot with a shotgun. He killed himself. This guy found him. The first thing he did was go buy a disposable camera and take pictures of it, which they then later used on their record.
Did the rest of the band know that it was that's what it was?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Like, this is awesome.
Well, what happened was because the reason that Euronymous gave, I think, for eating and making the necklaces and all that was that he wanted to be the most evil one in the band.
That is pretty evil. He's making a strong case.
So he didn't even kill the guy. He just found him.
No,
and
he found the guy dead. The guy
and
committed
then decided
suicide.
To eat him?
And, well, he claims that he made a stew with part of his brain or whatever, put some of his brain in there. Now, I'm not sure I believe that. Anyway, the story continues that eventually him and Varg have a falling out, and he's going to, like, they're preemptively, Varg Vikernes goes down and kills him.
Yeah, I remember watching there's a thing on that Vice.com. There's, like, a documentary about that guy.
There's several about Varg Vikernes.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's a case, man, that guy.
Yeah, he's a little creepy.
Well, he's, like, a strong nationalist. Aryan nationalist and has his weird views on those sort of things.
So anyway,
good music though.
Can't find it.
You just can't listen to what they're saying.
No, you can't understand a word.
You can. You gotta listen.
And last week we talked about the Japanese guy who served up his own genitals to in a banquet.
That's right. That's what we talked about last week. That was similar. What's going on around here?
There was a lady in Texas too that killed her 3-week-old son and cut him up and ate him too.
Oh, jeez.
She did?
Yeah.
Oh, that's what you get for bringing Brad in here. Stories like that.
I think people are just crazier than they've ever been. I think people are getting crazier. Oh, yeah. A lot of more drugs.
Yeah, it's the bath salts.
Yeah, bath salts mixed with what, you know, a lot of people are prescribed drugs. And some of them just lose their mind a little bit, I think, huh?
The name of that documentary me and Saucy Joe were talking about is called Until the Light Takes Us.
Right, and that's not just about Mayhem. It's about the whole scene at the time,
yeah.
The black metal scene.
Taking viewers deep inside the notorious inner circle that promoted murder, suicide, and church burning in the Norwegian black metal subcultures of the 1990s.
The thing is, these kids, they were kids. They were 15, 16, 17, 18-year-old kids that were just like, disenfranchised, dissatisfied with what was going on. So this is what they ended up doing.
That's a pretty hardcore form of rebellion.
Sure is. But it became a whole scene, and they were all trying to outdo each other, all the different bands.
And they were all, like, burning down. Yeah. One burnt down one church, so the next band went and burnt down a bigger right. church, and fucking creeps.
Churches are like, what's going on?
Well, it's all these old stave churches. They're like they're Christian churches, Christian stave churches that they didn't. These kids were all pagan or whatever.
Sure.
So they want they're into the old gods via their music and cool image, and they burn down these Christian churches. Since Christianity kind of did come in and burn down all their churches
Uh-oh.
To begin with.
What was that we just heard?
What?
A lighter?
No, I don't think so. So, Dandy, I promised before you arrived that you would tell the story you told me about the service that this guy offered for your dog.
Oh, dude wants to jerk my dog off?
Yeah, you let it lead up to it a little bit. The cat's out of the bag now.
Yeah, you beat around the bush there.
You let the semen right out of the dog there, my friend.
No lead-ins. We're jumping right in.
Well, tell him, how did he come about getting to that offer?
Well, I can't.
No, let's just leave it right there.
Let's just leave it.
I think that's a better story now.
I mean,
no, carry
hey,
on.
If it calms my dog down, dude, he can jerk him off just as long as I don't have to watch.
Doesn't something you could do, though?
What, jerk my dog off?
Yeah.
No.
Just seems like something you could do at home.
No, man don't want to do that to his own dog.
He's got nothing else to do.
It's gross and kind of creepy.
It's your dog. It's creepier than someone else is jerking off your dog, I think.
Hey, if I don't have, as long as I ain't got to watch it.
Now, I'm sure a lot of people are wondering why. Why would this guy want to do it?
Because it's supposed to calm him down. Because I'm not getting him fixed until he's fully grown, so I have to wait, like, 18 months, 16 months.
And the reason for that is that they stop growing if you...
Yeah, if I chop his nuts off, he'll...
No more testosterone production.
So I want him to get fully grown, and I'm not taking him out to relieve himself on female dogs.
Sure.
So this dude said he would jerk him off.
Now, what's the charge for a service like this?
Nothing. I ain't paying him shit.
So he's like, hey, I got an idea. I know how I can help you out.
Why don't you
bring that big, strong young dog in here? Let me relieve some of his stress.
You finally got to meet the pig.
It's a win-win.
In real life.
He's big.
I'm saying turn that wild animal loose on the neighborhood.
I brought him to the bar, tried to hook him up Friday night, but didn't work out.
He did take a big dump on the sidewalk.
He did, too.
Now, there's pictures of him holding court at Bulls Run Grill in Seneca Falls.
He was.
I'll post it.
He should be the... Actually, that might be the episode photo that we used today.
The dog sitting at the bar with a fucking beer bottle and shot in front of him.
He should be the logo Bulls Run Grill. He's a bulldog, first of all, right?
Yeah, I posted it on Facebook as Bulls Run Bulldog.
Yeah.
He should be their official mascot.
He should.
It only makes
he
sense.
He needs a
Except
name,
he
though.
It's too freaking barky when he's in there.
What's his name?
Because we got to tie him up outside.
He would not shut up.
Kingston.
Man, that could work. He may need a stage name. No, like Spuds McKenzie, you know? Like, this could be I don't know.
Are you saying that Spuds McKenzie wasn't that dog's real name?
I doubt it. I doubt that. Well, you know, maybe they signed him up and they were like, well... We're not going to ask you to change your name.
Right. You know, we don't like it, but... You
know, we'll work around it.
See what happens, and it became a phenomenon.
Yeah, the McKenzie family is poor but proud family.
Yep, they were.
Spuds.
He could surf.
What kind of dog was that?
It's called a... it's a bull terrier, I think, right?
Yeah, it's a terrier.
It's a bull terrier, I think.
Cool looking dogs.
Hells yeah. They got like a long snout.
If my dog had a long snout, I'd have punched him right in it today.
Why?
Fucking chewed my watch case.
His face is more punchable as it is.
Where are you going to put your watch now?
Like, I couldn't punch my dog in the snout. It's just this long, pointy thing.
Yeah, it's what you got to catch him from the side.
It looks like you already did punch your dog in the face.
Right,
no. Your dog probably feel good on your hand.
Yeah.
Got to work out on his face.
Where are you going to put your watch now?
I got four of them. They were in like a nice case with a glass top.
Well, that's you're like all blinged out or whatnot. I didn't know you. That's how you lived.
Silver.
So cool, man.
Silver square head.
face.
That's ballsy, having a watch case like that.
Your dog's genitalia is so big that he can't even sit down right. He's normally got to sit to the side. Yeah.
Did you see it? Did he sit for you the other night?
Yeah, he sat right down on his side, displaying his manhood for everybody to see.
You could probably get a fair price for that yam sack in Japan if you tried. I'm just saying. Once you decide to do it,
yeah, do you think the vet'll give it to me?
Find some prospective buyers. It's yours.
Sell it off as human. Sell it off as human.
I'll cook them. I'll bring it here.
Exactly.
And we'll say they're
with mushrooms.
Gizzards.
With mushrooms. Oh no, don't do that. I would say fly to Japan, put an ad on Craigslist in Japan, offering like the other guy did, the genitalia for 10,000 yen. Yeah. A plate.
Oh, speaking of yen, I had one. I used it as a ball marker. I used it as a ball marker today.
Speaking of balls.
Damn it.
You had some yen?
You don't got it in your pocket anymore?
It's in my golf bag.
Ah, that's too bad.
I think it was actually 10 yen.
That's like a cent.
I think it was like a dollar. No. Yeah, wasn't it like 10.12? 100,000
yen was like $1,000.
10,000
yen. 1,200.
Right. Was, yeah. 100,000 yen was $1,200. So 10 yen is like less than a cent. Or a cent.
They can't have less than a cent.
It must have been like 100 yen.
Why? They just don't have anything that's less than 10 yen.
I think it was called a yan yen. Y-A-N.
So you just think it was 10.
No, there was a number 10 on it.
Oh. Hmm. Yeah, but in Japan, that could mean anything. That could mean like kitties.
Yeah, good.
There's no rules over there. It's a different world.
Could have been fake from a Japanese Chuck E. Cheese.
What that guy did wasn't illegal, for God's sake.
No.
He
now, if it was somebody else's fucking testicles, would it have been illegal?
If he cooked someone else's testicles?
Yeah, but I was like, I'm going to cook my balls. And you were like, no, cook mine. No, I cook your testicles?
Oh, in Japan? You're bringing it back to when that guy shot that other guy in the leg.
Yeah.
Right.
In Japan you can, because there's no law against cannibalism.
You know, you could probably do it in Sweden.
Oh, I'm sure.
You could probably do whatever you want.
Now, that dude that ate that other guy's face in Miami?
Yeah.
Did he live? Did he come out of the coma?
The face eater is alive.
No, the face eater's
dead.
Or
the guy whose face was eaten is alive.
Did he ever come, like, is he back to be like,
I don't know.
Is why this motherfucker bit my face?
He doesn't know. He was a homeless man who was, like, asleep.
Oh, yeah. So that dude just ran up to, like, a random...
How did that happen, though? How can some guy just, not just lay there? Obviously, the guy must have tried to haul him down, but...
I think he tied him up first, didn't he?
No, it was on the side of a highway.
Stark naked, both of them. No bindings. He must have beat the guy down and then stripped all his clothes. The homeless man had clothes on to begin with.
Yeah, it was like on the side of an on-ramp right next to the Miami Herald.
Where a homeless person would sleep.
On an on-ramp?
In Florida, people are crazy there. He was probably wasted.
Miami's not really Florida. It's kind of its own...
Yeah, well, even worse.
Cuba North.
Even worse.
I still want to know why, what brought him.
Hi, Poppy.
just mowing down somebody's face.
Here's the theory that I read that I find most credible.
Meth?
No, whatever combination of synthetic mess that is, it raises your body temperature. This is what they said.
Oh, he was having things.
It raises your body temperature so to such a degree that you lose your mind. You hallucinate and go crazy. It just cooks your brain.
He thought he was eating a brisket.
What'd they call it? They called it something weird. There's like a name for it.
For what?
The
bath salts?
No. When you're, like your insides are burning up. I heard it called something.
Oh, yeah. I don't know. But that's, there have been other reported incidents of people doing this sort of thing. And it usually results in them eating people and killing people and eating them. And it's because they say their body temperature.
Like, these bath salts, are they that cheap that you can't just go out and buy a fucking $20 bag of cocaine? Do you have to buy this synthetic bullshit that makes your insides?
I think the bath salts are cheaper and they probably last longer. Or they're probably... Longer cocaine is expensive.
And they got to stop calling them bath salts.
Can't you buy them in head shops?
It's fucking confusing.
Well, not legally anymore.
Oh.
It's because they're not like...
They're not even bath salts. No, they just gave it that name. Yeah. It'd be like, I'd be sitting here drinking a Pepsi and you'd be like, oh.
Because, why? Because it looks like a fucking some stuff you'd stick in your tub.
But, like, bath salts aren't even called bath salts.
Some are. Like, if you go to, like, Bed Bath & Beyond or Bath & Body Works or I don't even know what the hell, a store with bed and bath in the name of it, you can get that kind of shit. It's, you know, like some purple fragrant thing you stick in a tub that my wife likes.
Yeah, but I don't think they're called bath salts.
They are. They're absolutely called bath salts.
Well, like now they're going to go away from it,
or
though.
Stuff yeah. like that.
They're going to go away from that, though. They're going to come up with the industry will come up with another name.
Sure, they don't want to be associated right. with zombies and eating people.
Right.
Imagine my wife freaking sticks that in the tub and comes out and freaking murders her
Eat
whole
your
family.
Nose.
Seriously, can't have that. But that's the thing; it's the total misnomer. They're Look not bath is, salts at
you
all.
Totally can't have that.
No, can't have it.
Yeah, I
see. You type in bat like real bath salts, and you don't even get what a real bath salt is. It's all about drugs.
It is now. 10 years ago, it wasn't.
It was just bath salts.
You
want to
know the meaning behind the name bath
yes,
salts?
Yes, tell me. Let's hear it.
Hang on. Open up, bitch. First off, you must define what you mean by bath salts.
Exactly.
Do you mean the stuff used for baths? Although this is a common misconception, real bath salts have no recreational purpose. Now, if you're referring to one of the many substances that can be found in that unknown powder known as bath salts, then a better question would specify the exact substances. The most common found in this research chemical blends are MDPV, methadrone,
yeah.
and methylone.
Which is similar to ecstasy or MDMA.
They could probably, in this day and age, all these products can somehow be used to get high somehow. Like any modern product just about. I bet you somebody can figure out
Yeah, but
out
that's
a way.
Not what these are. I mean, they're synthesized from certain things like that, but that's not what this is at all.
Now,
this
you want to know
chemical
the real problem?
Synthesis of what?
You want to know the
this
real
is
methadrone.
Problem? This is like...
The real problem with bath salts
yes,
is there's no way of knowing what the mysterious powder you're
right.
holding.
Right, you can't know what's in there. But it's chemically similar, and it's all in its cocktail form to MDMA or something like that, which coincidentally raises your body temperature. And that's why kids die on E because of their body temperature. Gets
the yeah, last, they're not drinking water.
The last right. release of bath salts are of a new formula, and the crap that may circulate the streets has no classification whatsoever. It's most likely a completely unknown mix of powder nowadays, so it's ignorant to assume that the name bath salts means the same thing in all cases.
Right. It is ignorant.
It's just, there's no regulation of something called bath
salts. It's more
common
for people to end up naked and wreaking havoc because of PCP.
Right.
And what better way to wreak havoc than eat face?
Like the Coney 2012 dude who just got crazy naked and lost his mind and ran around for a while.
I just saw that video 2 days ago for the first time.
Bath salts, man.
wasn't he in town at some school?
The organization was at the school.
He was just
ripping off
random,
our local youth.
He was just on some random street corner. Just jumping
yeah.
around.
Yeah. Oh, that guy, yeah. yeah. They got the,
he was like the he's the
producer or whoever yeah. did the documentary. Yeah. Dandy. Yeah. He was naked, like stroking himself on yeah. the fucking street corner.
I think next week you should
bath salts challenge.
I'll do it, but you got to go to the store and buy them.
Why is it? Why I'll buy. What?
You can't get them at the store, man. Not we anymore? Just didn't we just go over that?
I'm pretty sure that fucking gas station on the way through Waterloo has them.
Yeah, that might be true. You might be right about that. If we get 100 likes on Facebook, Danny will.
I'll jump out of a plane on bath salts with half a parachute,
while eating the person your instructor.
Yes. Yeah.
Imagine that. He would have nowhere to hide.
I guarantee we could get 100 likes on Facebook with that as a reward.
Just go on there now and do it.
I don't think Dandy's in.
To what?
To the eating.
We talked about cannibalism last week and he wasn't in then.
Nah, I'm not a big cannibalism guy.
Well, listen, I'm going to play you this boxing video right now because it's so funny.
It is.
It's a former boxer named Eric Kelly. Maybe you've seen it. And you podcast listeners, don't worry. We only play videos that are audio friendly as well on the Sauce Pod. So you'll enjoy it even if you can't see the pictures. But this guy's a former boxer who was injured in a gang-related incident.
Some sort of altercation. He mentions it in the video.
That's true. And so now he can't fight professionally, so he trains. And the gym is right next to Wall Street, so he gets a lot of Wall Street traders in. And he totally, you know, berates these folks. It's kind of funny. He's a funny guy, and it's a funny video. Let me cue it up.
And we like funny stuff, so...
We minding my business and leaving yours alone. We talking about me. Your job is hold the camera, motherfucker. Eric Kelly, born in Titusville, Florida, raised in Brooklyn, New York. Fuck up, boy. 4-time national amateur boxing champ.
That's a hook, we taught.
2-time New York City Golden Glove champ.
I can't believe you're still on this side of the dirt. I really can't.
2000 Olympic team alternate.
Where you get the old ass Top Gun haircut from?
2-time ranked number one in the USA.
Why you poking your ass out like that? You know you want somebody to get behind you?
Also ranked number 4 in the world.
As long as you been coming here, you don't know how to slip and go to the body?
Dumb motherfucker, boy. I had a pretty successful amateur career.
Eric Kelly, clearly the hungrier fighter.
However, I got injured in a street altercation. Left eye got hit.
It was a street altercation.
So that gave me a floater in the nerves and the muscle in my eyelid are very weak. However, I'm still doing something I love, boxing, training people. Even though I'm training a bunch of fucking nerds, Wall Street guys, no coordination. They're just not athletic people. They got me here. There. Look at this motherfucker right here on the back. Look at this motherfucker here on the back. Look at the uppercut. Look at the uppercut like this. Hey, do your uppercut again.
Is it good or bad?
Terrible, like the worst thing in the world.
Jesus, double jab, right uppercut, left hook, right hand. Double jab, right uppercut, left hook, right hand. Do it. Go home.
A lot of these cats, I wish they'd just forget the address to the gym. You know, everything is not for everybody. You don't see me going to motherfucking Wall Street picking up a fucking briefcase trying to type, do you? Because that's not what the fuck I do.
I don't think you can do it.
You know what I mean?
You can't see the keyboard with that Google eye.
I want to come here feel like men at the end of the day. Because, oh, I did something. I punched the buzz. Yeah, you was a fucking wuss. You know, and you couldn't last a day in my shoes.
Why you got this shit all up? How the fuck you gonna boil your fist? You got this shit all up down your fucking knuckles, you dumb shit. You wrap the knuckle, but you don't come all the way up to the middle of the finger. Somebody to show you how to put on your socks. You look like all the nerds just had a convention on your body. Like all the nerds of the world to say, you know what? I know where to go. And they chose your punk ass.
Motherfuckers beat you up as a kid and they still do today. You're a grown ass man. I bet somebody gave you a wedgie on your way here. I bet you fought thread come out.
Like I said, it's just not built for it. Everything ain't for everybody. See, they cut from different cloths. Some people is cut from leather. Like, you take a person of my caliber. I'm cut from leather. I'm cut from suede. You know what I mean? I ride the bullet. That's what I do. Woo!
Body locks. What's going on, body locks?
Look at that motherfucker here. That motherfucker here about 5 different colors. Count the different colors in his head.
It's like every earth tone in the color matrix.
I got the color, let's go, baby.
Where you get them young ass shorts from? It's like 1972 NBA Eastern Conference Final shorts.
You gotta dance after, bro. Hell no, you can't even do this, much less dance.
Hey, it's a job, you know what I mean? And especially in America, you having a job is a blessing. And doing something you love is a blessing, even if the people are miscreants.
You're horrible at your job, dickhead.
You know, that's how it goes. I mean, I got a few people that I love, and the staff is great. I couldn't ask for a better staff. If I couldn't ask for a better job, they make this worthwhile. It's just that some majority, most, practically all these motherfuckers here suck.
Now, if that guy was my boxing coach.
Church Street Boxing Gym, where everybody come to get fucked with. Who's gonna be the MC? I guess they wanna tempt me to clown these lazy, raggly, stupid dudes whose style are so corny. Yeah, they making money working on Wall Street, but in their mouth is where all the balls meet.
I would wait for him to turn his head, I'd poke him in his good eye, and I'd fucking throttle him right in the throat.
Oh, absolutely.
Wow.
Wow, that's a good plan. What a
dick.
I think he's funny.
I think he's funny too. But
yeah, but you know, these guys are trying to come in and work out, and you're gonna.
He doesn't seem to be helping them.
No, not at all. Not one bit.
My favorite part is when he gives that guy the confusing combination to try, and that just like belittles him because he can't get it right.
Go home.
I couldn't even. I've watched that video 3 times now, and I still don't remember the combination.
Yeah, I don't either.
Jab, jab.
It was a double jab. I know that.
Uppercut.
But then there
left
was
hook, right hand.
Well, I go home, man. I should just go home. You got it.
Yeah, go home, you corny motherfucker.
You're corny.
No, you're not corny. You're coney.
Coney.
You look like all the nerds in the world just had jumped up ahead of convention on you. Those are 1982 Eastern Conference Final shorts.
No, the best is when he said all balls meet in your mouth.
good for Eric Kelly. He's made a name for himself.
He's internet famous.
He's an internet meme.
Yep. Another meme brought to you by the podcast Sauce.
So my daughter came home from school today.
Good, I'm glad.
And she said,
it's a good start.
Daddy, I ate lunch at school today, because she never does. I don't blame her. I never did.
No, it's garbage.
She said they had stuffed shells. She said, your cheese is better, but their noodles and sauce were better.
What?
I'm like, shut your mouth.
Get to your room.
Come on. And so now that's her thing.
Telling you
she'll
that
tell everybody.
Bad sauce.
Well, no, she likes my sauce, but apparently what they produce at the Frank Knight Elementary School.
Out of the number 10 cans.
Yeah.
They just cut open, drop on there.
But my cheese is better, so. Oh, well. Got some items here that I cut and pasted, if you guys are ready for that.
I'm ready.
Let me pull it up here. Anybody in the chat room tonight? Any email, Dandy? Any of that stuff going on?
Nope.
Neither.
Really?
Wow. Paulie always was in here, but I think he got angry because you told him mics were muted.
Well, that's why we were waiting for you. I think everybody left when they were waiting for you to show up.
I won't be here next week.
No? How come?
It's going to be rough.
Late golf night, 6 o'clock. So you guys just go ahead.
We're going to have to find a suitable replacement.
Angry Brad and...
Brad will be at golf. See,
but Brad will be golfing.
Yeah.
Oh, everybody's golfing late?
Yeah.
Yeah, why is that?
Start.
Oh, there's some tournament, I think.
Tournament.
We're going to find a suitable replacement.
It's the Orange Pack tournament, probably. Right?
Yeah, probably, huh? It's that time of the year. Want to golf in a golf tournament 16th?
No.
What tournament?
I don't know.
For my father's.
Oh, it's the
softball.
Union Spring softball team tournament? Yeah, sorry. Where is it?
Which call it?
Oh, it's a Big Oak in Geneva. That makes a lot of sense. Is there any golf courses over there in Cougar County?
He said that's the best price.
Ah.
All comes down to the almighty dollar.
I see. You know, we talked about having candy bar contest, and I don't think anybody mentioned turtles.
Because it's not really a bar.
But it's one of my favorites. I broke down. I don't like to buy any candy bars anymore, but I broke down and got some turtles. Today, the one thing I don't like about them is there's 3 of them in the pack.
They have to do that to make them look like a candy bar.
Right. But I'm satisfied after 2, but I will always eat the 3rd. Can't just let it go to waste.
They know that.
You know, maybe even 1 turtle would do it, but the single turtles that they sell are huge, so it's like 3 mashed into 1 big turtle. You know what I mean?
I do.
Yeah. I got a question for you computer nerds. How do I get this fucking spam off of my Twitter?
You might want to talk to the guys on Tech Talk Live.
Yeah, call them.
This is the
Saturday morning at 11 a.m. Call in.
This is the second time I've tweeted. This is the exact message that I keep tweeting. Yo, make a side income filling out some surveys. They pay you $4 to $40 per survey. 2 days in a row now. And I didn't tweet this.
Oh, they're sending a message to you, a direct message at you, right?
No, I tweeted this out.
Oh, you did? You've been
hacked. Somebody fucking hacked me.
That's not.
But this is all they keep hacking me with.
Not spam. You want to know how to do it?
Change your password.
I don't know my password to begin with.
Say, I forgot my password. They'll send it to your email address.
And that'll stop these people from
getting
in.
And then you can change it. Yeah, that's how they're getting in there.
Make it a harder password.
Is they have your password.
Yeah,
You may want to change your password to other things too, if it's the same password, which I know it is.
Yeah, make it something
most
harder.
Of the same.
I don't know.
Is it Dandy number one? Dandy one. You need to come up with something a little more complicated. Speaking of passwords, you should probably use a combination of letters and numbers.
Oh, I do.
And use a capital letter in there too, if you're.
I do that too.
Do you? Oh. Well, you've been hacked, my friend.
I thought you said you didn't know your password.
Most of them are like my cat's name and a number, my dog's name.
So if you want to know how to get into all Dandy's stuff, all you got to know is his cat and dog's name.
Yeah.
Most people's passwords are pets and stuff like that.
Yeah, I think the statistics on that kind of thing are pretty wild.
My mother's and father's password for almost everything at their house contains the name of my childhood cat that's been dead for 20 years now.
They love that cat.
He was a great cat. She was a great cat.
Cat was around before computers.
Yeah, as far as cats goes. Now she lives on as their password. It's kind of weird, you know?
I saw a video today of a guy in, I think it was Finland, who his cat died, and what he did was had it taxidermied. He made a helicopter out of it.
Did you see that video?
I was going to cut and paste and print it, but I didn't.
He had it taxidermied so that its arms and legs were splayed, like, right flat out. So, and then he put four helicopter turbines on, like, the on each leg.
You ever seen that guy who lives across from St. Pat's with his dog stuffed in his front window?
No.
Right in the front window where probably where he used to like
to
hang
out. Oh,
I've
absolutely seen that.
Yes, you have. Yeah.
Well, it doesn't fly around.
No, it does not.
That cat lives on in helicopter form. And it actually flies.
It's weird looking,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, it flies. Yeah. You ever see the quadricopters, like the quad rotor helicopters they've been making lately? It's just like that, but made of a cat. With its arms and legs straight out. I guess they're all legs or all arms. I don't know what you call on a cat.
I think they're legs.
They're all legs. All four legs straight out to the side.
Good call, Brad.
I don't know. Cat arms.
I took a video of me getting my nose waxed the other night.
Did you?
Yeah.
Oh, that's right. I remember that.
Wasn't very good, though. Oh. I thought it was going to hurt a lot more. And
didn't.
What's
happening over there?
Lame.
Noises.
I think I found the cat.
You just need to see a picture of it. Yeah, look at.
Oh, my God.
It's this real cat. Why just gonna fly away?
Oh, that's fucking great.
I know it's horrible, like, because that was once a living creature, but.
That's amazing.
Right. It's inside that is helicopter parts and batteries and whatnot. And now.
Not a very good video, but.
Well, it's zoomed in a little bit too close here.
I think he's tracking it with another helicopter cat. And that's why it doesn't look as good. Look at
it. That's weird. Oh, man. Helicopter cats. What's next?
There you go.
Holy shit.
I'm glad I could contribute.
That should be involved in a laser cat video on Saturday Night Live. Helicopter cats and laser.
I don't think that would be legal.
Is that in America? That's in
Finland.
No,
it's in some Scandinavian or...
Desecrate. Well, I don't know. You can stuff, you know, you can.
That's what I said. I mean, you can. It's your cat. You can taxidermy it, right? I mean, you can do.
I'm not sure PETA would be cool with that.
What's the difference between stuffing your pet and putting them on the windowsill and stuffing your pet and putting helicopter turbines on them and flying?
You're flying a dead cat around.
But it's all cured and.
Yeah. Taxidermy.
Preserved.
No. You're saying if your son was outside and he runs in, he's like, Dad, there's a cat flying over the house.
I would say.
You don't think that would startle him a little bit?
Yeah,
or?
Probably would. But.
Tell him to lay off the weed, boy.
Yeah, bath salts.
Speaking of laying off the weed, how about this one? Pot-smoking mother drives off with baby on car roof. Oh, boy.
Dang.
That's why they call it dope.
Phoenix, Arizona. A marijuana-smoking woman, which is a funny way to say it, was arrested on Saturday in Phoenix after she accidentally drove away with her 5-week-old son in a child safety seat on the roof of her vehicle. The baby fell off the car in the middle of an intersection and was found unharmed and strapped into the seat, said Phoenix police spokesman James Holmes. The mother... Catalina Clouser, 19, was booked into jail on child abuse and aggravated assault and blah, 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 blah. It appears the suspect put the baby on the roof of the car and drove off, forgetting he was still on the roof, Holmes said in a written statement. I love the police statements. And then it goes 2000 Ford Focus, driving under the influence. Clouser apparently did not realize the baby was missing until she arrived home.
Why do they include that kind of information in the article? Like, some guy thinking, man, I wonder what kind of car she was driving.
That's 2004 Ford Focus. That's a 12-year-old car. She's a 19-year-old girl. Probably she's got a 5-month-old baby, you know.
No, I don't know.
I just see if she's just, you know, seems like a loser to me. Because of the Ford Focus.
That's what I'm saying. I'm driving a 96 Oldsmobile Bravada right now.
That's true.
You know?
But it's in great shape.
It is in great shape. It's got stickers that say, never forget 9/11 stuff on the side. I love America. It has a bumper sticker that says, I heart SF.
Yeah, which is great. That's like a classic. That is, that you can't get bumper stickers like that anymore around here. They used to be commonplace.
Why do you love San Francisco?
You could go to San Francisco and get one. I think that's where that's actually from, because her uncle lives in San Francisco. My wife, whose grandfather's car is what I'm driving right now, to be clear.
Jake, do you have a baby yet?
No.
No baby?
Nope. We're close, though. I'm saying this week, man. It's happening.
So are you saying that next week, if he has the baby and you're not here, neither one of you guys is just going to be me?
Yeah.
Hey, Tony, sometimes.
Sorry, I'll be too busy leaving my baby on the roof of my 96 Oldsmobile Bravada.
Tony, sometimes here. With episode 57 of the South Spot.
It's really lonely in here.
I have no compañeros. Okay. Do you know that Sesame Street songs were allegedly used in the Guantanamo Bay interrogations?
That doesn't really surprise me. Dang. What Sesame Street songs?
A new documentary alleges that detainees at Guantanamo Bay were tortured by being forced to listen to songs from Sesame Street for days on end, which is like the last 5 years of my life.
Yeah,
you know,
right.
So I don't get it. That doesn't seem like too much of a. It was torturous, but I don't know if it would break a man. Although if you're from the middle, you know, if you're a member of Al Qaeda,
listen. Listen, Al-Qaeda members, if you want to know real hell, come to the United States and get married and have children and have them play Barney all the time in Sesame Street.
Blah, 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 blah.
2004 Ford Focus.
The filmmaker's first reaction was that this just can't possibly be true.
Really? But why not?
Yeah.
What song? All songs are annoying if you play them for 3 days in a row.
Yeah. Especially some of the children's songs.
Except for Dandy by the Kinks.
Yeah, that one we could stream 24/7.
It's my song.
Here's a good one from La Mesa, California. Police follow discarded wrappers to theft suspects. Police say they followed a trail of discarded food wrappers to track down four people accused of stealing from a Little League snack bar. La Mesa Police Sergeant Colin Atwood, probably Colin, tells UT San Diego that police were called late Thursday about noise at the Rolando Little League snack bar in Rolando, coincidentally, Rolando Park. Atwood said officers followed a trail of empty cookie chip and Cheetos packages for about two blocks to a home where more snacks were found in a car.
I'm glad that's solved.
Yet they later found a bunch of other stuff. Two women and a girl were arrested. One man as well.
Sounds like something like Milhouse and Bart Simpson would do.
That's what I thought. It's like this is like a commercial or a cartoon. They walk in two blocks and they're just eating so fast and discarding rappers. Stuff, just scorching themselves that they could follow a trail. That seemed kind of silly to me.
It's good. That's some fine police work, though.
Absolutely.
Lieutenant, I think I see another one.
This looks like a trail. They were hot on the trail.
Oh, this is definitely the hallmark of the Cheeto Bandit.
Here's one. Here's another one. Probation for a Colorado woman who slid buttocks crossed $30 million painting. A woman who punched, scratched, and slid her buttocks across a $30 million painting by abstract expressionist Clifford Still at a Denver museum has been sentenced to 2 years probation and have to undergo mental health treatment. Carmen Tisch, 37, pleaded guilty earlier this month to felony criminal mischief for striking at and leaning against the oil canvas painted in 1957-3 number 2 at the Clifford Still Museum last year. After causing an estimated $10,000 worth of damage to the painting, an intoxicated Tisch then pulled down her pants, slid her buttocks against the painting, and urinated on the museum floor, prosecutors said. So, yeah, I mean, there's nothing really special about this except I like the urinate part on the floor as if it wasn't enough.
Right.
You know.
To add insult to injury.
But terrible reporting. What's the motive? You know, why?
I can offer this to that story, and that's that. I've said the term abstract expressionism probably 3 times in my life, and one of those times was just before the show when me and Brad were having a conversation about art.
That's weird.
About a painting that he bought at a garage sale, and I asked what kind of painting it was, and we determined it was an abstract impressionist painting.
Yeah, I'd like to see this painting so we can compare.
And then you said in that article, abstract expressionist.
That is weird. Does the painting compel you to wipe your buttocks up and down on it and then urinate on the floor?
No. Absolutely not.
That's not good art then.
See, she punched it, ripped it, kicked it or whatever, and that's what did all the damage.
Yeah.
And but the article title was that she rubbed her buttocks on it.
Right, because I wouldn't have read it if it was just woman damages $10,000 to damage to painting or something.
What is it, $3 million, that painting? Is that what you said?
Oh, no, not quite that much, I don't think.
Because that's what Brad's is worth now, I think.
She cost $10,000 worth of damage. Oh, yeah, $30 million. $30 million. How can a painting be worth $30 million? The guy's dead.
It's worth what you pay for it, you know?
The author's dead, so that usually raises the value of art because they can't create anymore at that point.
That's true. I heard that art was dead anyway, so.
Maybe she was so upset that the painting was worth so much that she just, you know, that didn't make sense to her. And she defaced it. She urinated on the museum floor, though. It was like, she was probably crazed. It was probably bath salts.
It probably was. I don't think I've ever purposefully rubbed my buttocks on something that I wanted to, like, do damage to.
I did it to somebody's face once.
Yeah, see, we're talking about me here.
Yeah, so
you rubbed your buttocks on something. Whoop-de-doo, everybody knows that. Everybody knows you rub your buttocks on things. There's
nothing wrong with it.
And you mark your territory, your house. Everything in your house has had your buttocks rubbed on it.
This is mine, this is mine, and this is mine too.
Then you sniff it. If it's not strong enough, you rub it some more.
Every Friday night.
Yep.
Re-ups. I gotta re-up. My butt wipes.
I was home in bed early this Friday night.
I believe it.
How's your deck coming?
It's done.
Is it?
Been done.
You should have posted a picture of that to Facebook.
Should have. And after that hurricane, I cemented them posts in nice and tight. Didn't even move.
Oh, so it was done before the storm?
Yes.
Yeah, we didn't really talk about the storm because last Monday everything was normal. And then the next day after we recorded episode 55, it was like bang. Dang.
Yeah, it was a rough week for the Seneca Falls citizens.
Yeah, geez, I have storm stories, but at this point I've told them so many times
I was without power for fucking 2 days. I'm gonna kill somebody.
Yeah, so was I.
I'll tell you what, the terrorists, they don't need to spend all this money flying planes into fucking buildings and making bombs. Just fucking cut our power.
It's all just find the master switch and cut it.
Yeah.
I would have. See, I could have killed somebody.
Probably the best way to do that would be to fly something big like a plane into a power plant locally. So
That's all computerized now. You can fucking push a button.
You get boom.
You gotta like get in there.
And I bet you there's not one button that you could push. I bet you it would have to be a series of buttons.
They probably need a password, and it's probably the name of your childhood cat to do it.
Head.
Head, that's right. It's the name of your cat, Head.
But yeah, like cutting electricity would be a good start. Yes, I don't know. It's not that easy to accomplish, I don't think.
I didn't, I mean, I had to cook four steaks last Wednesday or last Tuesday night just, for dinner. Just so they wouldn't go,
they were
bad.
Go bad.
I was going to take a picture of them, post them on Facebook, and say, don't judge me.
You need to get a.
But I forgot.
You need to get a cooler and some ice.
I did situation. That. But I still had to throw away probably $100 worth of food.
Really?
I just fucking pounded all the claim stuff it. That wasn't going to make it.
I don't have renter's insurance.
Oh, too bad. You don't?
I just found out today that you can get renter's insurance.
You yeah. can? Yes. Well, too late now.
Yeah.
All that food's gone.
Go through whoever your vehicle is.
My dad showed up on my doorstep like a ice fairy and brought two bags of ice to me and was like, put these in your fridge, in your freezer. And I did.
Really?
We lost no food.
My mom went to my house and checked on it. She goes, oh, everything's good. Your windows were open. It's a little wet.
I tell you,
I didn't get brought nothing.
I was a little weird for a while with the no power situation, but it came about 8 o'clock, 7:38. It started to get a little dimmer outside. And I was like, time to get out some candles. You know, it's going to be one of those nights. You remember those nights where you have to put out some candles once in a while?
I went to bed at 8 o'clock.
Yeah, you know, that's one way to solve the problem. But if you're like me and you're not about to go to sleep at 8 o'clock, I'm more of like a 2 o'clock kind of guy. I got some candles out, got ready, set them up where I wanted them. I'm telling the story right now, Dandy.
Arrange his bath salt in a row.
I did. I got. My wife actually did take a bath. My pregnant wife took a bath with candlelight.
I took a shower the next
morning. I set that shit up for her.
And I caught my windowsill on fire.
Nice work. Nice work.
I didn't think about it.
No, I set all these candles up. I got a book I was reading. I'm reading a book on my Kindle right now, so that wasn't going to work out. So I was like, it's hard to read by candlelight in a Kindle. It's like,
oh no, not good.
It's all right. The glare is a little worse. Anyway, so I was like, I got an old standard paper book, one or two laying around still. I'll grab one of those baddies. So I did, and got all settled in on the couch. I played my guitar for a while. It was nice. Noodled around. Got that book, sat down. About 9 o'clock, my power came back on. Just as I was
9 o'clock.
Yeah, 9 o'clock that night. 9 o'clock
got
Tuesday.
The same day.
9 o'clock Tuesday.
The whole south side, north side of the canal.
Yeah,
got
we were back
at nine.
Yeah, we were back that night. Well, the thing was, I was all settled in with candles and book. I was snuggled on the couch with a blanket and shit. And then I thought to myself, I should just stay here. You know, this is nice. And then 5 seconds later, I was sitting at my computer, like, let it all go.
My fucking lights didn't come on until like 7:30 the next night.
I felt guilty getting up from that. Nice. It was like a nice old timey.
I hung out in the backyard with the dog, played catch for a little while I was cooking my steaks.
There's got to be a word for that feeling, you know, of being without something that's so familiar. That
lost.
You just kind of, yeah, you are essentially lost. You kind of wander around a little bit.
I had
bit,
nothing like, that I could do. Like, there was nothing for me to do at my house besides sit there and throw a ball in my backyard to my dad.
That's what I mean. Like, some
absolutely
people are obviously
nothing.
Better suited to handling a situation like that.
Dandy just throws a ball, gets the wall. What kind of one after another electricity comes back?
I have no books.
3 days he threw a ball.
I swept up the kitchen. I swept off the back deck. You know, there was like really absolutely nothing for
I went to Chino's to get dinner that night.
Yeah, that's the thing. You could actually just go like one town over and live in the real world again. But
it was great. Everybody there was just loving life. Everything was normal. Then when you come back through town, see people just wandering the streets in packs.
That's what I'm
checking
saying.
Shit out.
Yeah.
They don't know what's going on. There's no lights anywhere, and that's bizarre in itself.
No street
that's
lights.
That's one thing I did notice. At like nine, once it hit like 9 o'clock, I woke up to take a piss.
Fucking quiet.
No, it wasn't, because everybody in my fucking neighborhood somehow has a fucking generator.
Oh,
so
yeah.
I thought I was camping. All I could hear were crickets and all fucking night.
Wow. Yeah, I didn't think about that. It was pretty quiet over in my neck of the woods. But imagine that happens on a larger scale. Like, you know, not countywide.
The blackouts
but,
in New York City. And
right.
Like, it's hot.
Now that, the blackout, the big blackout that happened in the city in 70, whatever it was, 71 or 72.
Whenever Berkowitz
yeah.
was killing people.
Yeah, it's not the same thing.
That was insane. I mean, people
died.
Lost their minds, yeah.
People died.
Riots and just craziness. They wandered.
Old people.
They wandered in massive herds down the highway, you know, like. Because the traffic lights were all messed up. They got out of their cars and just wandered.
That's another thing I don't like. when the traffic lights are out, people act like fucking idiots. It's whoever pulls up to the fucking light first, you prick.
It's like a stop sign.
But people do that at four-way stops anyway, and I always complain about that. It's the most dangerous thing you can do. Just pay attention to the rules. There's one rule. Whoever's there first goes. If you're there at the same
rule
time.
Rule number two, yeah.
If, you know, then that guy goes. But
if you get there at the same time, it's the guy to the right.
To the right, sure. Because why would it be the guy to the left?
But here's the thing. If I feel like I'm going to get there at the same time as somebody else, I slow down a little bit so I don't get there at the same time as them. I solved the second rule. I don't need the second rule.
Yeah, I think we've talked about this before where I've arrived clearly after someone and they're to the right.
And they're like, come on.
And they keep waving.
We'll wave.
No, this is taking longer than what if you just went.
This is going to be a good old-fashioned standoff, I say to myself, because I'm not going, guy.
I don't need a favor from you, jerk off.
The favor you're doing, everyone, is that you're going to cause an accident.
You know why people do that? Because they're a dickhead in real life, and they think, oh, I should probably do something nice to equal
it out.
Yeah, I think karma is going to kick in for him.
Not at that point, prick.
Women don't usually wave on. I don't see a lot of women waving on.
I get a lot of old women that do that.
Do you?
Yeah.
You get a lot of old women.
They prefer not to go first. They want to
it takes them half an hour to fucking get through it anyway.
They want to be safe. Let that intersection clear.
Fine Young Cannibals in the chat room wrote three notes while the power was out.
Now, here's a crazy fact. During the power outage, I learned to play Drives Me Crazy by Fine Young Cannibals on my guitar. I figured it out during the power outage. Crazy. What's going on tonight, Brad?
I have no idea.
That's another coincidence of things.
It is another coincidence.
Let me see if there's any more as I tell you about the story of the cleaning fairy accused of breaking into home, cleaning it. An Ohio woman has been accused of breaking into a home, cleaning it, and leaving a bill. Local NBC affiliate WKYC reports that Susan Warren broke into Sherry Bush's home, leaving a bill for $75 along with her contact info after cleaning the house.
That's just like a guerrilla business tactic.
Yeah. It's like, cleaned your house, here's the bill. Even though you didn't request
it. It's like when you're at the intersection and the guy washes your windows and then is like, hey, give me a couple bucks.
Exactly.
Same deal.
Have you ever actually had that happen?
Many times.
Sherry Bush.
It's funny. It kind of happened to me yesterday.
What? Someone cleaned your house and left
you
a bill?
No, I called this guy to come and roll my lawn. Well, come and give me a price on rolling my lawn.
He just rolled it.
I hear the truck pull up, waiting for a knock at the door. Hear lawnmower start. Hear my fucking hose on the outside of the house turn on. What's going on here?
He's filling up the...
Filling his roller up. And I was like, hey, what's going on? He's like, you called to get your lawn rolled? I go, no, I called to have my lawn...
You called for an estimate.
Yeah,
right?
An estimate. He goes, oh, it'll be about $50. I'll be out of your hair in about 20 minutes. It's like, whoa!
Now go back inside.
All this, since that storm, all the people, crazy lawn care people are out doing their thing.
But I got to give it to him. He did a good job. He rolled. He must have went over my lawn 5 times. He was there for about 45 minutes. So I figured $50 is good enough. If he only went once, I was just going to write a check for $30 to tell him to fuck off.
That could have got interesting.
I didn't give him the okay to do it.
No, you didn't.
Can't charge me for something.
Didn't even have a verbal contract with that guy.
And he had some fucking serious raccoon eyes. He must sit on that lawnmower all day long.
Raccoon eyes.
So wait a minute, whatever happened with this cleaning fairy? Nothing?
No, things happened.
I want to hear about it.
Things definitely happened.
Said you got arrested.
Yeah, but that's not the end of the story, is it?
Bush thought that Warren had come to the wrong house and called to straighten up the matter. She said she was driving down the street and randomly picked our house and cleaned it because she was desperate for money. Warren apparently admitted that she often does this practice and had chosen the Bush house at random. No items were stolen from the home, but Warren has been charged with felony burglary, which I don't know how you trespass, but if you don't take anything.
Or breaking and entering.
But
there's no burgling.
She'll get out of that one. There was nothing burgled.
I wonder if she ever had any repeat business. Like someone was like, oh, thank you.
You did such a good job.
You want to come every week to do it. I mean, you would think that would be her ultimate goal.
But next week, I'll give you a key, or I'll be here to open the door.
don't next time don't break my upstairs second story window to get in. Thank you.
It's really strange. She would just drive down the street and randomly pick a house and clean it and then leave a bill.
If you're desperate.
I think you're better off just sending bills. You know,
bills to people?
There are companies, especially in the internet world, that will just send bills to like thousands of people. And you know what? A percentage of those people pay the bill.
Yeah.
Even though they don't know, you know, especially with domain names. You know what I mean? They'll send, if you own a .com, you know, business owner or anybody, you can own a .com or .net or .org or .us or sure. .co or .tz or
any of those.
You get the point.
Like angrybreadrules.to.
Yeah. And then they would send Angry Bread, some other company who you didn't register with, will just send you a mailing and it will say, you know, $49.99, your name is going to expire. Send it here. But they used to veil it as you thought you were renewing your domain, but what you were really doing was buying a listing in some stupid directory, you know?
Right. Small print.
Yeah. So that's a great business model. No service, just invoicing. You know, they only need one department, billing department, and receivables.
You know, and then they don't even have accounts. It's just receivables.
Yeah.
Not accounts receivable.
They don't need to track the unpaid. Yeah.
We don't even have accounts. It's just receivables department.
They have a mailing room and a mailing room and a accounting department.
Out and in.
Yeah. That's crazy. But the sad part about it is they probably made a ton of money. Because people a lot of people just get an invoice and like, I better pay this as it's past due in 3 days. I don't want my credit to go bad.
This cleaning lady didn't make any money.
No, I think she was probably a little crazy too. Most of these people in the stories that we're reading tonight are probably just a little insane.
Well, it said this lady's done it before. Does it say anything like the people of success paid her and the...
No, this is crap journalism. I mean, these people just
you're furthering it.
You just need the headline, right? You need the headline. You get the page view.
They got us.
There don't need to be substance. Yeah, I'd like to know that. I mean, obviously there were other victims. Let's hear from those victims.
I'd like to know if she brought, if she came prepared with like letterhead with her name on it, you know. Or if she just like also found some lined loose leaf paper in their house and scrawled it with a crayon that their kids had laying around.
Surprise! I just cleaned your house.
The cleaning fairy.
the cleaning fairy. Oh, that's great. Now she probably just hand scribbled a note because, like I say, she's probably crazy. Probably crazy. Squat down toilets will boost Nomura, shareholders say. With investment banks facing an uncertain future, one Nomura shareholder, which is some Japanese company, has come up with a novel suggestion to help boost its share price.
What is that?
Replace all office toilets with Japanese-style squat facilities. All toilets within the company's offices shall be Japanese-style toilets, thereby toughening the legs and loins and hunkering down on a daily basis, aiming at achieving four-digit stock prices.
What correlation?
This was in their annual meeting.
Oh, man. I just don't see the correlation between rising stock prices and squatting.
By squatting, they're going to toughen their legs and loins. How can that not
translate into higher stock prices? I can tell you, it will not.
After their loins are strengthened, they'll serve them at a banquet and charge 110,000 yen a plate.
So that's sweet, sweet loin money.
The company can surely avoid failure if they straddle over a Japanese-style toilet every day and strengthen their lower body. If it cannot, it can only be accepted as bad luck.
Fucking Japanese. What is that?
That's how Japanese operate.
Well, that article is clearly translated from the Japanese. Like, it made no sense whatsoever.
Well, we can try these squat toilets, and if that doesn't work, it's just bad luck.
I think this is a great idea. I would wager that every article in every newspaper in Japan ends with, or else it's bad luck. That's just what it is.
I'd really appreciate it if we stopped talking about squatting on toilets.
Squat toilets, why you gotta go?
Yes.
It's bad luck, man. It's really bad luck.
Let's see here. The the bank share, or when considering the proposals for the shareholders meeting, we take relevant action in accordance with the law. The bank share price dropped below 1,000 yen, $12.75 American, late in 2008 and has not reached the four-digit mark since then. The unnamed shareholder submitted 100 proposals to be voted on at the meeting, including changing the company's name to Vegetable Holdings.
Japan is so great.
Though only 18 met the bank's requirements for them to be submitted to shareholders, and the bank's board of directors opposed all 18. So this guy, an unnamed shareholder, submitted 100 proposals. 18 were accepted for discussion, and all 18 were turned down, including the squat toilets.
And turning their name to Vegetable Holdings.
Other suggestions include abolishing the practice of giving three bonsai cheers at the annual meeting because too many shareholders having strong armpit odor.
What the fuck?
That will surely raise the stock price. But this, what's funny is that company actually has approved a policy of giving three bonsai cheers at the annual meeting.
Bonsai!
Bonsai! Bonsai! The proposals aren't all as far-fetched, however. One of the more conventional suggestions was that any capital increase should be funded by rights issue rather than public stock offering. Oh. And that any decisions on public stock offering should be subject to a resolution at shareholder meetings to protect shareholder rights.
I'm pretty sure they just stole that from the part of Karate Kid when Mr. Miyagi's all drunk. Yeah. He's like, Bonsai!
Because his wife died.
Well, that's how they do it in Japan.
I can sing that song, too.
Haven't you seen that one car movie?
When he's drunk?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
You got to do it, Dandy. All
right. Don't put the camera on me. I won't be able to do it.
Okay, don't put the camera on him until he started.
Oai. Ukiyo no. Uamasito. Gi, oh no. That's all I know.
Why do you know that?
Because me and a kid that I grew up with thought it was fucking hilarious. We were younger, so we like remembered most of it.
It is hilarious.
When we get drunk, we still to this day will sing it to each other.
I remember that. I'm a big fan of that movie and a big fan of that scene. I remember Daniel-san puts Mr. Miyagi to bed. He puts Mr. Miyagi to bed after that.
He does.
Tucks him in.
Daniel-san.
He's wearing his uniform. His military uniform. No, he's wearing his military uniform.
Oh, yeah. From Mr. Okinawa. Miyagi is.
Oh, he's a little drunk and he looks at pictures of his wife.
It's because it's her anniversary and she's died. She's dead.
I'm starting to sweat a little bit.
She was also... Oh, no, wait a minute. That's what I'm thinking. Now I'm crossing into Karate Kid 2 territory when Herm and Sato were in love with the same woman.
Oh, yeah. Originally. The lady that takes away or takes care of his father. Yeah.
That's really funny.
Kumiko.
I love that song.
I love it now, too.
Next time I get drunk, bring it up.
I will.
I'll get right into it.
Wow. Got a little teary eyed.
Oh, I'm so hungry.
I guess the Sauce Pod is probably one of the few American podcasts that focus weekly on Japanese culture.
We do.
I want more of it.
Those fuckers glow in the dark now.
What?
Japanese people.
Because of the nuclear reactor?
Yeah.
I don't know.
It's in, like, baby food and shit. It got into, like...
It's an interesting scientific theory you're proposing, Dandy.
It's not a theory. It's the truth.
All right.
Bad what luck. The radiation got into
it'll
the...
come up on one of these articles eventually.
Yeah. Certainly.
I bet you fucking Eric Kelly... If he ate some of that baby food, it'd open up that wonky eye of his.
You think so?
Have to.
The company can surely avoid failure if they straddle over a Japanese-style toilet every day and strengthen their lower body. If it cannot, it can only be accepted as bad luck.
It's the only thing that can be accepted as bad luck.
The plan is flawless. Just circumstance and bad luck could thwart it.
What is a Japanese-style toilet?
They're just basically holes
in the
floor.
A hole in the ground?
Do they flush?
No.
No, you, like, squat over it, facing it.
I'm sure it flushes, though.
No, they don't.
No, they're just holes.
They're holes in the floor.
So it's like an open porta potty?
Yeah, it's like a, it's not a big hole. You stand, you put your legs on either side of this hole, and then you squat down.
Haven't you ever watched Mr. Baseball before with Tom Selleck?
Did they do that in that movie?
Oh, yeah.
When he gets into the bathtub before he takes a shower, and the guy tells him it's like jerking off after having sex.
So where does it go when it goes down the hole?
Into a tank? I would imagine.
Probably in some sort of crazy Japanese sewer system where little cats run on treadmills and see, who knows what's underground in Japan.
Weird because they have those squatting toilets, but then they also have the...
Komodo?
Is that what it's called?
Where they shoot the water up to clean you?
No, it's called a bidet.
That's right. I'm talking about the toilet seat that heats up and sprays your ass. And how can you go from having like the best toilet seat in the world to then having holes in the ground?
Because that's the old style. It's
for the lower class Japanese?
Well,
they're shitting holes?
That's by like lower, you mean closer to the ground, yes.
Maybe the public ones are just the holes.
And imagine you walk into a public bathroom and you have to pull your pants all the way down.
I'd shit in the sink.
And squat down.
You got to take your pants off. You got to take your pants off.
You have to squat like a frog, so you have to do something with your pants.
Well, think about it.
Do they have like bars that you can
you'd have to have something to hold to.
Yeah, so it's like shitting against a tree.
Yeah, it's certainly a fine, it's conducive to shitting, that position. But
and then the shit goes down into a hole on a conveyor belt by cats, and then it is formed into patties by Japanese girls as they sing, "Oh la la, me like no money."
Yeah, and they all have and they have giant eyes. Their eyes are all really big, and they blink.
And every fifth patty, they giggle. And then they go on, "Oh mama, no show me la money." And there's no purpose to it other than if that doesn't solve their current economic crisis, it can only be accepted as bad luck.
It's just bad luck. Man. I think the Japanese are the most naturally funny people of all time.
Sure.
They are fucking goofballs.
Like that, they just have such a high tolerance for silliness all the time, and no matter what they're doing, like they're perceived as very serious. But this guy is like in a big business here, and these are his proposals.
How are they perceived serious? You ever seen them fuckers sing karaoke?
Well, they have a lot of
How do you take them serious after that?
Have you ever seen Iron Chef Morimoto?
Who
fillet exactly? Tuna?
No.
You know, there's a lot of honor, there's a lot of bowing, a lot of reverence for the elderly and things like that. They're all very serious.
They worship Godzilla.
Yeah, but out of a billion people, there's going to be a few crazy ones.
I don't think that that's the crazy ones, though. I think normal. That in general, they have a high threshold for silliness. Like, I think that they just are silly people.
They buy fucking used panties out of, like, vending machines in Japan.
Everything is crazy there. It's very silly.
Very crowded, too.
That might be the start of it.
Could be. It's always been crowded.
Overcrowding.
We didn't talk about that again for another week. We haven't talked about the mice.
I'm taking overcrowding.
We don't have time either.
I know. I'm saying again, maybe overcrowding is the beginning of the end for the Japanese.
I'll tell you what's going to be the beginning of the end for this guy.
What? You said you were going to tell me. No, do it.
I was going to say something else, but I'm going to shit my pants.
Oh. It's time to go then. Danny's in dire. Look at him. He's in dire need of relief.
One last quick story. Back to America for this one.
Oh, this is going to be boring then.
It is kind of boring compared to that last one. Arizona man's hairs get cash found hidden in walls.
Nice.
Phoenix again. An Arizona court says a man's hairs are entitled to $500,000 cash that was found in the walls of his former home after he died.
Best. It's the dream. That's the dream.
Yep. It certainly is. This guy stuck cash. He died in 2001.
How much?
$500,000. According to the ruling, his daughters found stocks, bonds, cash, and gold, of course, hidden in his suburban Phoenix home before they sold it 7 years later.
In the suburbs, no less. I love guys like that.
Can you imagine if you moved in, like if they never knew it was there and you moved in and started doing some remodeling?
Yeah. And found gold.
But the bonds and shit are in his name, so you wouldn't, that would.
Sure.
You'd fuck yourself.
But the gold.
Yeah, but the gold doesn't have his name stamped on it.
Think they have to pay taxes on that?
Probably.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, they would have just unless, like an inheritance.
Yeah, yeah.
They shouldn't have fucking said anything if they were smart.
The government ain't letting $500,000 change hands without getting a cut of it, unless it's between multinational corporations, and then it's okay.
Unless it's for...
Yeah.
That's interesting. That is the dream, though, finding $500,000 in your wall.
Anywhere.
It's one of my dreams,
I find it anywhere.
It's 100 times more American than my dream. House is worth.
Right? Money for nothing.
Yeah, no doubt. Chicks for free. That ain't working. That's the way you do it.
So, you know, that's all the stuff I got here. Anybody, any parting shots, fellas?
I'm going to leave you a parting shot downstairs.
Listen, you guys, send us an email at info@thesaucepod.com about anything.
Please.
Especially if it's Japanese. If you notice anything in Japanese culture you want us to talk about, info@thesaucepod.com. Visit us online at www.thesaucepod.com. We're on Facebook. Search for The Sauce Pod. We're on Twitter. Search for The Sauce Pod. We're on Stitcher. Search for Finger Lakes 1. Now, what Stitcher is, we talked about it before, but honestly, get it on your smartphone device and access the world. Take the world of podcasts with you and internet radio anywhere you go that you have an internet connection on your phone.
Do it.
But, yeah, you plug that into your car stereo. You put in your headphones when you're mowing the lawn. But you could be in Japan and listen to The Sauce Pod if you had Stitcher.com.
Listen to me sing Japanese music in Japan.
And, of course, we're on iTunes. I don't know if you heard of it. It's a new music service Apple put together. If you do listen to us on iTunes, how about leaving us a review or rating us? It will help us rise in the rankings.
Rise.
Now on YouTube.
We are. Our presence on YouTube is strong now.
Yep, every episode's going up on YouTube by the next day as well.
Brad looks terrified.
No, you guys are moving up.
It's just a matter of actually uploading it to YouTube. Actually, our account is enabled for more than 15-minute videos, so that otherwise it wouldn't work.
And you say you guys, you're here, man. You're on YouTube now too, fella.
Yeah.
Yeah. And
whether you like it or not.
You can subscribe to our RSS feed.
Deer breaks into mall in Ithaca, disrupts lunch.
Yeah, that's a local headline. I should have featured that one. And, of course, when we're live, we're on fingerlakes1.tv. So you can listen on your computer, your tablet, your phone, or your television. I mean, what more can we do for you people? Brad, thanks for coming in.
Yeah, thanks for asking me.
Appreciate it. You won't be able to fill in next week because you'll be the same place Dandy is. Joe and I have some figuring to do. I think it's Rudy P. Ringtone time.
Probably.
Don't you?
I do.
Hear that? Rudy.
Is he out there in the chat room tonight?
I think so.
I wonder if I'll be out too. I didn't even really think about that.
Now what will happen? I'll just find three random people.
And hope none of them will eat your face while we're doing the show.
Well,
yeah, you don't want that.
And a prerequisite I'll ask them all is, do you own bath salts? All
right, good move.
Make them wear a Hannibal mask.
That's another good move.
Yeah, who knows what next week will bring, but...
Rudy P. Ringtone says he's busy.
Of course he is.
Oh, yeah, he's really... That's why he's in the chat room every Monday night, but he couldn't come in here. Come on, Rudy P. Ringtone. Yeah, everybody knows that Tony sometimes hates Rudy P. Ringtone. Everybody knows that. From here to Japan.
Want me to take us out with our Mr. Miyagi song?
Yeah, one more time. Come on, baby. The fact that you're constipated makes it even better.
Yeah, that probably
do it over
sing.
The.
But
do
you
it
should
over
cut
music.
That as a clip so we can play that sometime.
Sure. I'd gladly cut it. It's going to be on. You kidding me? That's going to go viral on YouTube. I should just cut that part out. And
I didn't even see what my face looked like. I should play that back.
You didn't want the camera on you.
You look like a small
I saw my face.
You think I was going to let you see
I could see my big face right across from me twice.
You look like a young Pat Morita.
Kinda. It's kind of true.
God rest his soul.
Maybe next year. So. Dress up.
He's
for.
Dead? Oh, yeah.
You're full of surprises, Dandy.
I am.
I don't know.
I think so.
God, that froze.
Well, you know what that sound is. We've successfully completed another episode of the Sauce Pod. And we'll be back next Monday night. At least I will. Peace out, folks.
We hope you enjoyed listening to this episode of the Sauce Podcast. Subscribe to our feed at thesaucepod.com. Look for us on iTunes and Zoom Marketplace. Contact us at info@thesaucepod.com. Follow us on Twitter at twitter.com/thesaucepod. We'll see you next week. www.fingerlakes1.com